Hello everyone, this is your sexy moth king Bart Koppens, back again with another moon moth. And I know what some of you guys may be thinking, oh, another moon moth video. Because if you look at my channel, you will see a lot of videos showing many different species of moon moth. And the thing about these species is that in some cases they can look very similar. Now, in the Far East, in particular in the Palearctic Asia, there's a whole bunch of moon moth species out there that superficially somewhat look the same. Take Arctias selena and Ningpoana, but also species like Arctias gnoma, Arctias aliena, Arctias sucfisti, Arctias artemis, Arctias dulcinea, and the list goes on and on. And sometimes these species can be difficult to separate, at least by appearance alone. But the thing is, all of them are in fact their own unique species, so that does make them interesting. And me, being a pseudo-biologist online, is still someone that wants to see all of these species, even if they look the same. Because biology is not about looking for the most pretty things or the most variation. Biology is also about studying the subtle differences between some species. And that's what I also hope to do. Now, what I'm holding here in my hand is a beautiful looking male of Arctias aliena. Now, we've had Arctias gnoma on my channel before, we've had Arctias dulcinea on my channel before, Arctias artemis, and they all somewhat look the same, but not 100% the same. And what makes Arctias aliena unique is the shape. It has a very nice round shape, and it has these nice scalloped submarginal lines here on his wing. Can you see them? They're very subtle, these lines. That's how you recognize Arctias aliena. Last but not least, here is the purple part of the forewing, the costa. It's purple. In some species, this is white. For example, Arctias gnoma is also in Japan, but in Arctias gnoma, the top of the submarginal line on the forewing here has a white patch. I mean, here on its head, you can see this white, and in Arctias gnoma, the white runs along the top of the wing. And aliena has very little white scaling. Also particular is the curvy round shape. Species like Arctias gnoma is a little bit more triangular with very sharp edges and slightly longer tails as well. If you see them in real life, it's easy to distinguish them, but from pictures and videos, this may be difficult. And the eggs of this moth here came straight from a population in Japan. As you can see, when you touch it, it can be quite bothered quite fast. But all in all, this is a pretty awesome and amazing species, and I cannot wait to see a female hatch soon so I can breed them. Thanks for watching and goodbye. This was Bart Koppens with breeding Arctias aliena.